Hey guys, it's Chris from Fiscale RC Garage. Just a little update video on the Kraken. I talked to Clayton at Vertigo, got this clutch bell hopefully straightened out. That's all good to go. Upgrade to the RCR brakes. Getting the engine ready. Doing the awesome outover Velcro job. But that's it. This one I did last night. This one I did today. Put this all on my Turtle pull start. Just trying to get this thing ready to get in the car. Put my new clutch housing on with the FS clutch. And I'm just trying to decide. This is a version 1 diff housing, which is the smaller bearing. I do have the version 2 housing right here in the box. Let's see. I don't know if I should put that in now before I have any issues. Also, I have for the Vecta, thanks to John at Detroit Performance RC and Mike Taylor for making this. The RC Max front diff for the Vecta. Just wonder if I should put this stuff in now before I have issues. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, if I should go ahead and do those now or let it run for a while. Also, just a quick update, I just gotta say, I had the original steering servo. Man, it does not turn the vehicle good at all. Also, especially with these. Also with the Trepidors, does not turn very good. So that's why I switched over to the stock wheels and tires. But I got this servo from John, also at Detroit RC. It's a Hillotronics. Works awesome. Works really good. For the kind of driving I do, for bashing stuff, I don't need the dual servo setup in this. For now, anyways. If I ever do change, I'll do one of the big high-tech, like 1000 series. But man, that thing works really good. Let's see, what else has been planned? Oh, also have my OBR 30.5 reed torn apart. Got the new Turtle clutch housing, because this one's going in my 5SC. I don't know, a few little things going on. I was just happy I figured this clutch bell out. Like I said, I talked to Clayton at Vertigo. He gave me some pointers how to kind of really tighten on this thing really good. So hopefully we don't have any more issues with that. It's a beautiful setup. When I first ran it, I had the stock trans housing, and like one run, it blew out the bearings in it, right out of it. And I even used the green Loctite for like race installs. I think I have it here. I'll show you. Stuff still came out with that, so it's a must upgrade that. But let me know what you guys think in the comments, if I should put the version 2 diff in here. I don't have any issues with that right now, but supposedly they blow out the bearings in here. Or I have a brand new set of Team Fast Eddy bearings. I could take it apart and put the new bearings in there, because these are still stock bearings. They're not sealed. You know, the rubber seals in them. Also, yeah, I think that's about it. I'm trying to figure what else. Yeah, but that's about it on this one right now. So, like I said, if you guys can leave it in the comments section, if you guys think I should do it now, or just get it running with what I have. I don't know, because I got a lot of work to do on my 5SC. So this one's going to take some time. This one's getting a complete overhaul. I got a modified RC rear chassis plate. I also have a Kraken full chassis for it. So, yeah, let me know what you guys think. All right, thanks, guys.